Yeah.
Hey y'all, what is up? And welcome back to my channel for a current household update. So if you have not watched my last current household update, I suggest you go check that out just so you kind of are in the loop on who these Sims are, because this is the second generation update. I am doing the Not So Berry as my current household. I know it's kind of, I wouldn't say it's like outdated, but it's kind of like old news. Most people have already completed this challenge and have completed it at least 5 times. It's everybody's favorite. And honestly, I've never been a huge fan of challenges just because I feel so limited. But I've had so much fun with this. I've been able to, you know, explore parts of the game that I haven't before, which is the whole point of it. And the only thing that I do different is I don't go by the colors, really. I kind of try to theme their houses and their outfits and their style around the color, but I don't necessarily give them mint hair or red hair or yellow hair. I just can't with the colored hair in The Sims. That's just me. So anyways, in the last update, we did a little update on the first generation, which is the mint generation. I introduced my Sim to you guys, which was Maya, and I had introduced her family, her husband, and she had a toddler, and she had just given birth to our second generation heir, Madeline. I aged her up into a toddler, and she was really, really cute, and I told y'all I was going to play through their life, continue, you know, wrapping up all of the goals and stuff that I have to do in Maya's life. And then once I got kind of further along into the second generation and had given birth to our third generation, I would give you an update. So here we are with our second generation update. But before we dive into Madeline's life to see where, you know, she is, I wanted to hop in and, you know, check on Maya. So this is Maya. She has aged a little bit, but she's still absolutely gorgeous. And then her husband, Dean, I just checked because I haven't played with them recently. Like, I haven't hopped into their household since I've been focusing on Madeline. And they are so close to passing away. I did have their agent turned off a little bit, which, by the way, you're going to notice I don't really go by the rules, like, hardcore. Agent is supposed to always stay on, but I did flag them for no agent for a little bit, not very long. I wanted, you know, our third generation to kind of age up into a child so she would have a relationship with Maya, since that is part of the rules. But anyways, I think when I last updated you on Maya, they had already moved into their family home. And don't mind me, it is currently nighttime right now. It's 9:25 p.m. I don't have my cheats on, so I couldn't change the time for you, but it's okay. This is their house. Love it still. And I did do a speed build on this house, so if you are interested, it is available for download on the gallery, but it's very, very pretty. So they had upgraded to this family home, and we had our little lab over here, and we have added quite a few things to the lab. As she got promotions, she was obviously granted and given more little gifts, so we was able to add these into our game. And she was pretty much halfway through her career, and halfway through all of her skills that she needed and her aspiration. So yeah, we have completed everything. She is done. And it wasn't that bad. Honestly, the thing that took me the longest was getting her to reach level 10 of the scientist career. And then also this collection right here gave me hell. Honestly, it wasn't that bad. I found pretty much everything within a few like Sim days, but I could not find Phyraxium. Yeah, it was Phyraxium. Yeah, I could not find Phyraxium in anywhere. It's rare. Couldn't find it anywhere. I googled it. I tried to, you know, learn which crystals and metals it was found in. I had her analyze them, but I could never find Phyraxium. So honestly, not even gonna lie to you guys, I cheated. After I had her do the last thing, which I needed that last crystal, and then I needed her to reach level 10 in her career. As soon as she reached level 10, I had her retire, and then I just went into debug and found Phyraxium to complete my collection because I was so over it. So my bad, I did cheat there, but it's okay. So yeah, she did complete the Chief of Mischief aspiration. As you can see here, she has completed 4 out of 4. So, you know, she did have the opportunity to talk slower, Carissa, calm down. She did have the opportunity to select a new aspiration, but I decided not to do that. Just because I wasn't really focusing on her anymore, so what does it matter? And I just wanted to prove to you that I did it. And her skills, she has mastered the logic skill and the mischief skill, which was part of her little goals to, you know, move on to the next generation. And I don't have proof of this because I did have her retire, but she did complete level 10 of the scientist career and she retired. And I really wish that it would show us that. I guess I can hit play so they're not just sitting there. But I wish it would show that she retired and what level she retired at and what her pension is. I don't know why it gives you the opportunity to retire and then join another career. Like, why would you do that? But anyways, as far as her and Dean go, they're still madly in love. And Dean also, I think he reached level 9 of the Tech Guru career. So I had him retire as well. And, you know, he's pretty solid man, pretty solid provider in the family. And of course, the kids have actually aged up, obviously, and have families of their own now. So I do have these custom picture frames, which are custom content, and I love them. Thank you. I forgot who created these, but thank you. So I do have a little bit of memories here. So this is Gabriel and Madeline. I do believe this was when Madeline was a teenager and Gabriel was a young adult. Here is Maya and Dean. And then this is Dean, or not Dean, oh my gosh, this is Gabriel and his wife Stevie. So they've already moved out, and I'm going to give you a little update on Gabriel as well as Madeline, which Madeline is our second generation, so I'm gonna try to, you know, zoom on through. But here is just the little overview of the house. This was Madeline's room since she is the Rose generation. I did try to, you know, include a lot of red. I think her room turned out so cute, but obviously she has moved on. And this is Gabriel's room. It's, you know, pretty much the same. He kind of followed in his mom's footsteps, and he is in the scientist career as well. And after the kids moved out, their little dog died. Oh my gosh, what was his name? Winston. Yes, Winston died, and it was really, really sad. But after Winston died, I did have them adopt 2 pets, which are demon dogs. They are honestly the devil dogs. And this one really needs to go to the vet. but I'm not really bothering with her right now. So we have Ollie and we have Roxy. So they needed some little children, pet children, to occupy their time since they are retired and their kids have moved on. But anyways, yeah, so this is Maya. This is our generation one, our mint generation, and she is all done. As you can see, they have a lot of money, and I didn't even cheat that, honestly. They have just been bringing in the money. I think we had a little bit included when we had some of our spouse sims. I think Stevie moved in with us before her and Gabriel got married, and that probably added a little bit to our funds. But for the most part, they're doing very well. They're well off. And yeah, I'm really proud of her. But anyways, let me just tell you a little bit about Gabriel here. I'm going to insert a little screenshot of him and his family. So last time we played, Gabriel was he a toddler? I think he was a toddler. He might have been a child, but I'm pretty sure he was a toddler, about to age up into a child. But anyways, he definitely followed in his mom's footsteps. He's very, very smart. He has glasses. He very, very, very resembles her very, very closely. Like, they look like twins. But yeah, he has a very close relationship with his mom and his dad. And he actually dated a girl. Oh my gosh, I don't even remember her name. What was this girl's name? I don't even think, neither one of them know her, do they? Oh, I don't remember her name. But anyways, in high school, he dated this girl, and I thought that she was the one. Like, I thought they were going to get married. And when, oh, what was her name? Goodness gracious, it's going to bother me. Anyways, when they aged up into adults, he proposed to her, and she denied his proposal. Turns out she's non-committal, and so he broke up with her because he definitely wanted a family, and Stevie here actually was one of Madeline's friends, and I thought that they would be a really cute couple, and turns out they hit it off really well, and they got engaged, actually had a wedding with them, I moved them into their house, and they had a baby girl, her name is Kara, and she is super duper cute. So that is how Gabriel's doing. He's about halfway through the scientist career, so he's doing very well himself. He lives in Newcrest, but anyways, that's a little bit about Gabriel. But let's hop on into Madeline's household, because she is our second generation heir, so I'm gonna have them, you know, kind of go to sleep, and then in the morning I'm gonna pick back up with Madeline and introduce you to our third generation. All right, so here is Miss Madeline. She is all grown up. The last time we seen her, she was a toddler. She is now a young adult. She is, I think she's about to age into an adult within like 2 sim days. So yeah, I've been working on her really hard, and I think she is stunning. She is so beautiful. I love her. And you know what? Honestly, when I started this challenge, I remember I asked on Twitter what you guys' favorite generation was, and I had a lot of you say you did not like the Rose generation just because it was kind of like hard, it wasn't your cup of tea as far as like the serial romantic. And I was kind of going into this thinking, oh my god, this is gonna suck, everybody hates this generation. It's my favorite so far. I am enjoying her story way more than I'm enjoying Maya's. It hasn't been that hard just because I started playing her obviously since from birth, whereas Maya started as a young adult, so I'm kind of ahead of the game when it comes to her. But anyways, this is Madeline, and she does live in San Myshuno. I did do a speed build on this apartment that I furnished for her. We do have a little bit of changes here because we do have a child now, and this is her room, but I will introduce her to you in a second. Real quick, I want to kind of go ahead and tell you where I am with Madeline. So Madeline is a nonprofit director. She's level 8 of the politics career. So one of her goals is to master the politics career, and she does have work today in about 4 hours, but yeah, anyways, it didn't specify in the rules whether, you know, you did the nonprofit route, charity route, or you do the, like, the world leader route, and I just could not see her being, like, a president. I just imagined her, you know, being very into nonprofits and into that lifestyle, and a lot of that has to do with her best friend. So her best friend here, let me try to get in here, and I probably have a screenshot I can include, but I just love these little picture frames. So the blonde back there, that's her best friend, and I don't even remember her name. Why am I Nancy? So this is Nancy Ward, and they were friends as children. I had no idea that Nancy was Judith Ward's daughter until they became teenagers. So I did cheat her, and I made her an actress because she didn't have any fame or anything like that. So I did, you know, have her become a, I think she's like a rising star right now, but they are best friends. They're very, very close, and yeah, I just imagine that because of the popularity, you know, lifestyle that she lives and how popular and charismatic she is, that the nonprofit organization, you know, route type thing in the politics career, you know what I'm talking about? I get so tongue-tied, I don't even know what I'm talking about. But anyways, I just imagine that that would be perfect for her. So that is the route she's on. She's almost accomplished that. I mean, we are on level 8, so she's doing pretty freaking good there. She also is to master the charisma skill, and where are we at with charisma? We're on level 8 of charisma as well too. So like I said, I did start her pretty young. When she was in high school, I had her, you know, start on her charisma and doing speeches and stuff like that. Tessa's about to have to go to school, which is her daughter, our third generation, so I'm gonna pause it real quick. Probably gonna include a little bit of screenshots here, but another thing that we have to do is leave someone at the altar and master the serial romantic. So I'm on the last level, which is level 4. So I, like I said, I'm killing it. So we're on level 4, and we have to have 8 boyfriends or girlfriends. So far, we've had 4 out of 8, and we have to earn gold on 3 dates. So I'm kind of just taking my time with that because I'm already so far ahead, and she's about to turn into an adult herself. And also, like I said, she is to leave someone at the altar and then get married for the first time as an elder. So the man that she ended up leaving at the altar was Miss Tessa's father. And they started dating. It kind of just took off, you know, really fast. They fell for each other. And it was just kind of like that whirlwind romance. It was just, it happened so fast. His name is Sullivan Lee. He's an astronaut. So, you know, it kind of works out with Tessa being like an astronaut for the third generation. She's supposed to be really, really close to her grandmother, Maya, which she still is. But also, I wanted her to kind of, you know, have a relationship with her dad still. So I think it's really cool her dad is an astronaut. But anyways, she ended up, you know, planning the wedding, had a beautiful ceremony, and of course left him at the altar, as you can see from the screenshot. And as soon as she left him from the altar, she got home, a couple days passed by, and she was pregnant. So yeah, their relationship's not that bad. I mean, they actually get along pretty good for the sake of their daughter. And, yeah, so that is who she left at the altar, and I'm not really sure who I'm going to have her marry at the end. We're just going to play it by ear, but she has dated Owen Terry. She actually just broke up with him, told him that she wanted to be friends. Who else has she dated? I don't even know. It said she's had four. I don't remember having four. Oh, yeah, she dated Austin Reed. He is such a sweetheart. Like, they were really good friends. I don't know. She may marry him. I mean, he's very tatted up and not really her type, honestly, but I don't know. I can definitely see it. He's very good looking. And she also dated Zane Scott as a teenager. That was her first boyfriend. Oh, he's already married. Okay, well, let's not, like, ruin that relationship, maybe. She's really good friends with her brother and Stevie and her niece, Kara. Yeah, I think that's all of her boyfriends and girlfriends. Yeah. So, I gotta work on that, but pretty much, we're killing it. We're killing it with her. So, moving on to little Tessa here. So, this is our third generation, and I did say that I wasn't going to nitpick the generation, so I'm not going to say, oh, it's always going to be a girl, or it's always going to be a boy. It's just, I'm going to let the game, just sim fate, do its thing. And she ended up having a little girl first, and, you know, we're just going to go with it. She's only allowed to have one child, so this is Tessa. She's so cute. I love her. I love her room. It's very yellow because she is yellow generation, but also she's obsessed with space. So I did add, you know, a few little decorations in here that definitely portray that. I wonder if she can come clean this up. Yeah, okay. But yeah, she looks... Well, okay, I age them up just to see what they look like as a young adult. And she is a very nice mixture between her dad and her mom. So she's very, very cute. And I guess she can't get to that. That sucks. Okay, well, anyways, yeah, not much going on with her. She just aged up. Obviously, for her, we have to be very close to our grandmother and not have any close friends until she passes away, which, honestly, is the stupidest rule ever because it's just, I don't like that. And then also, Madeline is not supposed to have a good relationship with her daughter at all. I'm actually going to have her work from home today since we're kind of talking a little bit. But anyways, yeah, she has a very good relationship with her daughter, and I couldn't help it. It's just because she is the only one home with her. She's the single parent. So obviously she's caring for her. The relationship goes up. So she does have a very close relationship with Tessa. But as far as like motherly instincts go, I do believe she's kind of selfish in that sense. Whereas it's all about her and her career and her, you know, love interest over her daughter. You know, she doesn't spend a ton of time with Tessa. You know, she doesn't really take her to do things that she likes to do. Tessa usually has to call her grandmother for that, or either her dad, because like I said, I don't like that rule that she can only be close with one person. So as you can see, she's not even super duper close to her grandmother. I mean, they're friends. She's friends with her dad. She's closest to her mom, and that's just naturally because she lives with her mom. She's really good friends with her grandpa Dean. She's, you know, decently friends with Stevie, Gabriel, and Kara, but I'm not going to have her have any friends with children or teenagers until Maya passes away, which Maya's about to kick the bucket anyways. But yeah, she wants to be an astronaut, and she wants to have the handiness skill, all of that. I don't really have the rules in front of me because I'm not prepared, but most of you are familiar with this generation, and we're not really focusing on her anyways right now because this is an update on the second. I did just want to introduce you to our third generation heir, Miss Tessa. So anyways, y'all, that's where we're at. And I've been kind of like slow doing this. I feel like it's been a while since I did the first update, but I mean, I've just been doing a lot of building, and then also I'm 6 months pregnant, so I just kind of play here and there when I can. But so far I'm not bored. I'm having a lot of fun. I didn't think I would because it's a challenge, but yeah, we're killing it, and I'm proud of myself. But anyways, I'm probably gonna wrap this up soon because I just kind of wanted to give an update. But my phone's ringing. It looked like a, during free time, Tessa drew an inappropriate piece of artwork and showed it off to classmates. It caused lots of giggling and disrupted the rest of the school day. We encourage creativity, or take the drawing and punish her. I think just because I feel like, obviously, common sense, you would get on to your child for doing something inappropriate, but because Madeline is supposed to be not maternal, you know, in a sense, she's kind of just like carefree and whatever, you know, I kind of feel like that's how their relationship is. I did try to have her not punish her a lot as a toddler when she would make messes, so I think we're just going to say, yeah, it's fine, you know, we encourage creativity around here. But yeah. They have a pretty good relationship overall, but she's just a little bit, you know, careless. You know, she's just whatever. And I do want to plan a non-profit, like, party. We can do that. What's it called again? Hold on. Let's go to the calendar just so I can, because it costs money and I don't have the money right now. A charity benefit party, yes. I want to do that since it has a lot to do with her career. I think that'd be really fun to do, but I do want to, you know, earn a little bit more money because right now we only have 772 simoleons. I do imagine that they would move in the future, probably once, you know, we reach level 10 and we start getting a little bit more income. This is a very nice apartment. It's very spacious, but I don't know. I do see her kind of moving a little bit uptown once she gets, you know, on up there. Madeline Roberson's calling. I don't want to talk to you. What do we need to do today? So we need to paint a political mural and give a confident speech in uptown. But you know what? I'm not going to do that on camera with you guys just because I don't want to bore you. I know it's been a lot of talking, but I was just, you know, giving you a little update on where I am. Oh, also this right here, this is a picture of her and Tessa's dad, Sullivan. Yeah. So she still has a picture of them here, and I don't know, it's not in the rules. So I guess I probably could, but I don't know. I think out of all of her relationships, that was just kind of like her first, like, true love. And she kind of just freaked out. She's not non-committal, but she just felt like she was being held down with her whole career and life ahead of her. That she just kind of got cold feet. So I don't know. Maybe, you know, with Tessa growing up and them still continuing being close, maybe her and Sullivan will end up, you know, together in the end. She could marry him. As an elder, that is something that she has to accomplish. So, I don't know. We'll see. It'll be fun to come back once I give the update on Tessa. Just to see what Madeline, or who Madeline ended up with. But, anyways, you guys, that is a wrap, I guess you would say, for our little update here. Yeah. So, it's been a lot of fun. And I'm excited to see what happens in Madeline's life and Tessa's life. And like I said, I'm kind of going at my own pace here, so it could be a few more months until we get another update. But I did want to update you guys since I am almost done with her, and we have little Tessa, you know, growing up and, you know, learning stuff. I really need to get my cheats back after this update because she's super tired at school and she's still in her pajamas. She wore her pajamas to school. I mean, that's just another example of her not being very motherly. Like, who sends your kids to school in pajamas? It's like she's just so, you know, preoccupied with her career and relationships that she just didn't even realize Tessa was walking out the door in pajamas. But anyways, yeah, I'm wrapping this up, but here I am still rambling. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys like this little family. I love them. I've grown a little bit attached. But yeah, so give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you have not. And with that being said, I will talk to you guys later. Bye.